इनोवेशन एज कंटिन्युअस इम्प्रूव्हमेंट एज वेल. डिसरप्टिव्ह म्हणजे टोटली, आता फॉर एक्झाम्पल पूर्वी आपण भेटायचो आणि आपल्या सगळ्या भेटी या पर्सनली असायच्या, पण ह्या लॉकडाऊन आणि ह्या सगळ्यानंतर काय झालं, आपण सगळ्या ह्या मीटिंग ज्या आहेत ह्या व्हर्च्युअल व्हायला लागल्या. सो इट वॉज नॉट अ डिसरप्टिव्ह टेक्नॉलॉजी, बट टेक्नॉलॉजी वॉज देअर, बट ओव्हरऑल इट डिसरप्टेड द एंटायर वे द मीटिंग वेअर कंडक्टेड. आर्किटेक्चर चेंज, पूर्वी पेजर होते, पेजर दोन सेलफोन आले, पेजर निघून गेले, पूर्णपणे आर्किटेक्चर बदललं आणि काही रॅडिकल चेंजेस होतात, टोटल चेंज होऊन जातो आणि इथे आपल्याला कळत पण नाही की बाबा रे असं झालं कसं, पण ते होत जातं. आणि त्याच्यामुळे बिझनेसमध्ये जॅक मा नेहमी जे सांगतो ते आपण पण लक्षात घेतलं पाहिजे, नेव्हर एव्हर कॉम्पीट ऑन प्रायसेस, इनस्टेड कॉम्पीट ऑन सर्व्हिसेस अँड इनोव्हेशन. कारण एकदा तुम्ही प्राईसवरती कॉम्पीट करायला सुरुवात केली की तुमचा शेवट जवळ आलेला आहे. अँड दॅट्स वाय डू नॉट कॉम्पीट ऑन प्राईस. आपल्याकडे ही एक पद्धत निर्माण झाली की मी स्वस्तात देतो, मी स्वस्तात देतो, ह्या एकमेव आपल्या दुर्गुणामुळे आपण पुढे जात नाही आणि आपल्याला त्याचा खूप अभिमान वाटतो. पण त्याच्याऐवजी समजा आपण इनोव्हेट केलं, सर्व्हिसेस नवीन ऍड केल्या आणि जर आपण पुढे पुढे जात गेलो तर जो काय आपल्याला बेनिफिट मिळेल तो इनॉर्मस असेल. त्याच्यामुळे नवीन गोष्टी ह्या तुम्हाला नेहमी घ्यायलाच लागणार आहेत. सो देर इज नो टीचर हू कॅन होल्ड युअर हँड अँड शो द राईट पाथ. आणि तुम्ही सगळे लोक उद्योजक असल्यामुळे तुम्हाला सगळ्यांना याची पूर्ण कल्पना आहे की प्रत्येक वेळेला थोडस काळ आपल्याला धडपडायला लागतं. सो यू हॅव टू वॉक ऑन अ ब्रोकन ग्लास, एक्सप्लोर ओन अप युअर ओन ऍक्शन्स, आणि आपल्या स्वतःच्या ऍक्शन्स हे आपल्याला ताब्यात घेणं फार आवश्यक असतं. आणि त्यामुळे तो सेकंड पॉईंट जो आहे, द की ड्रायव्हर फॉर ऑल इनोव्हेशन इज व्हॅल्यू क्रिएशन, अल्टिमेटली द लॉंग टर्म सर्व्हायवल ऑफ युअर बिझनेस. त्यामुळे आपण व्हॅल्यू प्रत्येक वेळेला क्रिएट करतोय किंवा नाही करत आहोत याच्याकडे आपलं सतत सतत लक्ष असणं आवश्यक आहे. आणि ही व्हॅल्यू क्रिएशन जेव्हा व्हायला लागेल, ही व्हॅल्यू क्रिएशन जेव्हा व्हायला लागेल तेव्हा आणि तेव्हाच आपण पुढे जाणार आहोत. सो वाय शुड वी इनोव्हेट और वाय वी शुड इनोव्हेट. तर आता इथे मला वाटतं तुम्ही थोडंसं मला सांगितलं तर बरं पडेल की तुम्हाला काय वाटतं की तुम्हाला इनोव्हेशन का करायचंय, काय आवश्यकता आहे. इथे मी अगदी रेडीमेड दिले, याच्या पलीकडे पण काही कारण असू शकतात आणि ती असते
इनोव्हेशन इज सर्व्हायवल.
ओके, इनोव्हेशन इज सर्व्हायवल. ओके, सो राईट नाऊ यू आर थिंकिंग फ्रॉम अ सर्व्हायवल पर्स्पेक्टिव्ह. लवली, थँक्यू. केअर सर,
इनोव्हेशन इज टू फिल अप द गॅप.
फिल अप द गॅप, विच गॅप सर यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट?
रिक्वायरमेंट इन द मार्केट.
ओके,
गॅप इन द मार्केट.
ओके, so you want to get into that particular niche area. Superb, thank you Kalkesh sir, thank you. Anyone else?
For growth.
Okay, for growth. Okay, by the way, is it really essential every time that we should be growing in the business? Is it really essential? कारण हे पण एक आणखीन एक विचित्र आपल्या डोक्यामध्ये भरवून ठेवलेलं आहे की ग्रोथ 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 आणि ग्रोथ खरंच गरज असते का प्रत्येक एव्हरी नाव एंड देन ग्रोथची गरज असते का?
As long as inflation is there.
Sorry?
As long as inflation is there, growth is required, yes.
Okay.
To cope up, at least to cope up the inflation.
Okay.
Fine. माझं मत आहे, not only for inflation sake, पण to avoid stagnation in
Lovely.
Terms of your working pattern, it okay. is required.
Super. So, Palmini ma'am, you really are talking about one important point which many people miss. Generally, most of the business people, especially the SMEs which I meet, they always tend to talk about growth only in terms of money. And here, you are giving a broad perspective of the growth, and that's exactly where you can find various ways to innovate.
Innovation to make your end product, that is your customer, more happy. Lovely. Because he will bring in 100 more customers. One satisfied, in fact, customer.
Classic. Gauri ma'am, very correct. You are absolutely in the right track. And that's exactly what we all have to really look out. And that's why we should innovate for all these particular areas. Let me tell you, as we go along, you will find out in your own business where else you can grow. And even if at the end of my session, if you come out with such 4 or 5 additional areas to innovate, I believe you have started innovation. Because many times that broader mindset is very essential. And that's where exactly the design thinking will help you. So when I'm saying that design thinking is essential, it is essential at this particular point in time, that we have to broaden our horizon. So many times these kind of a pep talks are given Now, why people give a pep talk? Because it's very easy to advise somebody. But in our consultancy, when we handhold and take the people to the last stage for implementation, that's when people start realizing that actually we can make it happen. And that actually we can make it happen is more important. So you have to make it happen. And many times you as a business people, when you start working, you need to really handhold your team members, your colleagues, or people who are working for you. Otherwise, innovation is not possible. Because one man cannot do everything. In short, this is not a heroic effort. This is not a heroic effort. So now you just, this is precisely I have picked up from internet, the information, innovative countries. Okay. Now here, when we talk about innovative countries, so this is US, Japan, China, Germany, Republic of Korea, France, okay, UK, Israel, Taiwan. हे सगळे देश त्याच्यामध्ये येतात. ह्याचा आपण कुठेच नाही होत. भारत हा कुठेच नाही आहे. कोणी सांगू शकेल कारण का आपण कुठेच नाही होत? आपण कुठेच का नाही होत? आता तुम्हाला सगळ्या लोकांना एवढा अनुभव आहे, तुम्ही नक्कीच याच्यामध्ये मला मदत करू शकाल.
That is because we've been taught not to disrupt the status quo.
Okay. Yeah, you are right.
So okay. We let things be.
Okay, we keep the status quo. Next, chal raha hai, chalta hai. Okay. What else?
This is we are education system does not allow us to think.
Okay. Education system doesn't allow us to think. Okay.
Intellectual property cha baptit ajnan hai aani tyacha procedures aplyakade ajunhi complicated ahet.
Bas. Tyachyamule gadbad hote aplyakade.
इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी बद्दल अज्ञान आहे ना, अजून माहिती नाही आहे.
ओके ओके, आणखीन काय कारण
आहे?
आपले एज्युकेशन सिस्टम जे आहे ते मोर इन टू थेरॉटिकल दॅन नॉट इन टू प्रॅक्टिकल.
ओके, तुम्ही सगळी सांगितलेली कारण मला मान्य आहेत, सगळी सांगितलेली कारण मला मान्य आहेत. पण एक लक्षात ठेवा की आता आपल्याला चान्स आहे, कारण आता कोविडच्या नंतर जी काही सिस्टम झाली आहे, आय थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ अस हॅव कम ॲट द सेम लेवल. आपण सगळे लोक आता सेम लेवल आलो, कारण सगळीकडे जगामध्ये सेम चॅलेंजेस, सेम प्रेशर, सगळं काही सेम झालंय. त्यामुळे आता इथून पुढे जाणं शक्य आहे का नाही शक्य आपल्याला? नाहीतर हे इनोव्हेशन डिझाईन थिंकिंग शिकण्याला काही अर्थ राहणार नाही.
आहे, नक्की स्कोप आहे. बिकॉज ही जी तुम्ही वरती जी कारणं दिली आहेत, मेनली वाय दीज 9 कंट्रीज ऑर मे बी मोर कंट्रीज आर मोर इनोव्हेटिव्ह कंट्रीज, आवर इकॉनॉमी इज ऑल्सो इम्प्रूव्हिंग अँड आवर न्यू जनरेशन इज स्ट्रायव्हिंग फॉर बेटर स्टँडर्ड.
ओके, hello, I'm not able to hear you. By the way, I'm very hopeful. I'm extremely hopeful. It is possible. Only thing is that we have to adopt the new way of working. We have to be more open. कारण आता तुम्ही जी काही मला 5-6 कारण सांगितली, त्या सगळ्या याच्यामध्ये जो काही कंट्रोल होता तो कंट्रोल बाहेर होता. म्हणजे एज्युकेशन सिस्टमचा प्रॉब्लेम आहे, पेटंट लॉचा प्रॉब्लेम आहे, आपल्याकडे डेव्हलपिंग कंट्री आहोत, आपण आपल्यावरती कुठलीच जबाबदारी घेतली नाही. आणि मला वाटतं तिथेच सगळ्यात मोठा गोंधळ सुरू होतो. आणि आताची नवीन जनरेशन जे आता कोण शेवटी मला कोणी सांगितलं माहित नाही, पण त्यांनी जे सांगितलं की नवीन जनरेशन जी आहे तिला बेटर लाईफ स्टँड ऑफ लिव्हिंग पाहिजे, म्हणजे काय की ते पुढे जायला तयार आहेत, त्यांची इच्छा आहे. पण आता ह्या सगळ्या कंट्रीज ज्या आहेत त्या रोबस्ट इकॉनॉमी आहेत, हाय स्टँड ऑफ लिव्हिंग आहे, प्रोफेशनल अप्रोच आहे, हे सगळं जरी खरं असलं तरी आता सिस्टम असं झालेलं आहे की आपण सगळे लोक सेम लेवल आहोत. आणि त्याच्यामुळे आपल्याला कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ प्रोडक्ट अँड प्रोसेस इनोव्हेशन करणं आवश्यक आहे. नो इनोव्हेशन लास्ट फॉर लाईफ टाईम हे आपण लक्षात घेतलं पाहिजे. त्यामुळे कुठेतरी आपण प्रत्येक वेळेला नेक्स्ट स्टेजमध्ये गेममध्ये येऊ शकतो. आणि आपण त्या गेममध्ये येण्याकरता म्हणून जे जे काही लागेल ते सगळं करणं आपण आता आवश्यक आहे. आणि म्हणून तर हे सेशन अरेंज केलेलं आहे. एम आय राईट पल्लवी मॅम, एम आय राईट? इज दॅट द पर्पज ऑफ दिस पर्टिक्युलर सेशन?
येस येस डेफिनेटली सर.
सो दिस थॉट प्रोसेस बदलायची. आता तुम्ही बघा, इथे एक छोटासा मी तुम्हाला चार्ट दाखवतो आणि मग तुमच्या लक्षात येईल की बाबा रे, मी फक्त असं भारत 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 करत नाही की माझा खरंच माझ्या देशावरती विश्वास आहे. द थिंग्स विच आर इकॉनॉमिकली व्हायबल, सोशली व्हायबल, दे आर कॉल्ड एज अ इक्विटेबल. सो मोबाईल फोन कॅन बी कॉल्ड एज अ इक्विटेबल, इकॉनॉमिकली अफोर्डेबल, सोशली ऍक्सेप्टेबल एज फार एज इंडिया इज कन्सर्न. things which are socially acceptable, environmentally acceptable, they are bearable. Scooter, rather than four-wheeler, scooter can definitely give us the stuff. Things which are economically viable, environmentally viable, also environmentally acceptable are called as a viable. So train is viable mode of transport. And when we talk about sustainable, that is economically acceptable, socially acceptable, and environmentally acceptable. And let me tell you, as of today, India is actually sustainable. Now we really can take this particular phenomenon to the next level and ensure that all the products which we come out with, they will become sustainable. If at all we work on sustainability, one aspect, I believe we have done the wonders. And that's why my first question was, is it really essential to really grow in business? And most of you said yes. Rather, I would say our entire focus has to be sustainable. Growth will follow. But what happens is, we focus on growth and somewhere the sustainability at times get jeopardized. Now let's see, if at all I'm saying India is sustainable, look how other countries have taken it to the specialization. See, most of the time we don't realize. So when we talk about Japan, they have gone with the quality, and actually nobody can doubt about Japanese quality. Do you agree with me? When we talk about China, it's all about quantity. The way they have really set up their manufacturing base, nobody can touch Chinese people. Even today, whatever we may talk about, that we don't want Chinese product, we'll boycott Chinese product. Practically, it will be very, very difficult for the entire world. I'm not talking about India per se, because they actually have mastered this particular stuff. USA, the way they come out with the new products, the way they really register the patents, I don't think anybody ever has given, because they have actually inbuilt into their system, okay, coming out with the new products, new ideas, and actually they give life for that particular product. See, we don't go in this particular fashion. We always think about सगळं नीट आहे ना, व्यवस्थित आहे ना, घरामध्ये व्यवस्थित सगळं आहे ना, बँक बॅलन्स आहे ना, आणि इथेच आपण मार खातो. त्यामुळे एस गुरुमूर्ती जेव्हा सांगतात की आपल्याकडे ग्रोथ म्हणजे काय, तर ऍडिशनल एक बेडरूम विकत घेणं किंवा ऍडिशनल एक नवीन प्रॉपर्टी विकत घेणं आणि सेटल होऊन जाणं, कसं काय प्रॉडक्ट तयार करणार आपण. सो वाय यू एस इज कमिंग विथ द न्यू प्रॉडक्ट, बिकॉज ऑफ इट इज इन देअर कल्चर, इट इज इन देअर सिस्टम. दे डोंट माइंड टेकिंग अ रिस्क. इवन इफ दे फेल, they don't mind starting right from the scratch. They are not bothered about लोक काय म्हणतील, माझं काय होईल, आतापर्यंत असं झालंय, नथिंग ऑफ दॅट सॉर्ट. यू लुक ॲट तैवान, कोरिया, इंडिजिनस, स्वतःचीच प्रॉडक्ट डेव्हलप करतात, स्वतःची प्रॉडक्ट डेव्हलप करतात. वेन वी टॉक अबाउट UK, इट्स अ वेलफेअर स्टेट. ह्या लोकांनी आयुष्यात काय केलंय मला माहिती नाही, पण ते त्यांच्या सगळ्या नागरिकांना सगळ्या गोष्टी फुकट देतात. जग लुटलंय पण त्यांनी ते केलेलं आहे. नो दॅट्स स्पेशालिटी, वी डोंट वॉन्ट टू से एनिथिंग अबाउट इट. जर्मनी, इट टॉक्स अबाउट प्रिसिजन. जर्मन प्रॉडक्ट्स आर प्रिसिजन. त्यांच्या प्रिसिजन इतकं आतापर्यंत कुठलंच जगाने काहीही अचीव केलेलं नाही आहे. वेन एव्हर वी टॉक अबाउट जर्मन प्रॉडक्ट, वी से दॅट येस, इट इज अ प्रिसाइज प्रॉडक्ट, ऍक्युरेसीच्या वरच्या लेवलला गेले. वेन वी टॉक अबाउट इस्रायल, डिजिटायझेशन मध्ये आणि ओव्हरऑल त्यांच्या प्रिसिजन मध्ये खूप वरच्या लेवलला निघून गेले इस्रायल. When we talk about Singapore, एकदम लॉंग टर्म, तुमच्यापैकी किती लोक सिंगापूरला गेलेत माहिती नाही, पण सिंगापूर एअरपोर्ट तुम्हाला पाहिला बरोबर कळतं की काय विजन असेल त्या माणसाची. आणि त्यामुळे जर आतापर्यंत भारत हा सस्टेनेबल लेवलला चालला असेल, तर आपण समजा सस्टेनेबल ह्या हा एकच मुद्दा घेऊन जरी आपण पुढे सरकलो ना, तरी आपल्याला कोणी टच करू शकणार नाही. किती वर्ष आपण डेव्हलपिंग कंट्री म्हणून राहणार. एनी कमेंट्स? आय वॉन्ट टू लिसन नाउ. नाही तर इनोव्हेशन ह्या आपल्या लेक्चरला काही अर्थ राहणार नाही. एनी कमेंट्स ऑन दिस? दिस इज अ व्हेरी व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट स्लाइड, अँड इफ यू रिअली गेट कन्व्हिन्स अबाउट दिस पर्टिक्युलर स्लाइड, देन इनोव्हेशन अँड डिझाईन थिंकिंग इज पॉसिबल. हॅलो
हॅलो,
नो कमेंट.
सस्टेनेबिलिटी म्हणजे काय म्हणताय तुम्ही?
हा,
सस्टेनेबिलिटी मीन्स व्हॉट?
सस्टेनेबिलिटी इन एव्हरीथिंग. आतापर्यंत आपण कुणाकडे भीक मागायला गेलेलो नाही आहोत. आतापर्यंत आपल्याकडे जे जे काही रिसोर्सेस आहेत त्याचं युटिलायझेशन अत्यंत सुंदर चाललेलं आहे. कमीत कमी ह्याच्यामध्ये कसं राहायचं हे आपल्याला कोणीही शिकवायची गरज नाहीये जगानी. आजपर्यंत बघा, आपल्या देशामध्ये आजही जवळजवळ 20-30% लोक एकच वेळेला जेवतात, पण कोणी येऊन आपल्याला काय म्हणतात ना, आपल्यावरती दरोडा घालत नाहीये. आपलं नशीब खूप चांगलं आहे. लाईक कल्चरली वी can accommodate, we can accept, we can move forward, we can contribute. हा एक वेगळाच लेवल आहे आपली अख्खीच्या अख्खी.
मला असं वाटत, हॅलो, मला असं वाटत की आज म्हणजे आजकालचे जे यंग जनरेशन आहे त्यांच्याकडनं आपण खूप गोष्टी शिकू शकतो, कारण ते स्वतःला अपग्रेड करायला तयार असतात. आपण तयार नसतो जास्त, म्हणजे बेसिकली स्वतःला आपण अपग्रेड केलं. म्हणजे आजकाल ते म्हणतात ना की द ग्रोथ दॅट यू गेट इज द पर्सनल ग्रोथ यू हॅव इन युअर सेल्फ.
सुपर मॅम, सुपर, ऍब्सोल्युटली राईट. आणि इथेच आपण खरं पुढे सरकू शकतो. सो इनोव्हेटिव्ह एंटरप्रेन्युअर व्हेंचर्स, आता इथे मी तुम्हाला काही उदाहरणं देतोय, ओके. आणि इथे जेव्हा मी उदाहरणं दिली आहेत, ओके, याच्याविषयी काही खूप बोलायची गरज नाही, पण तुम्हाला जे काही म्हणत येत आहे की कुठली एक व्हॉट इनोव्हेशन दे हॅव डन, काय त्यांनी वेगळं केलेलं आहे. अगेन ओपन, एनी वन कॅन स्टार्ट टॉकिंग ऑन एनी ऑफ दिस पर्टिक्युलर स्टफ. आता हे सगळं तुमच्या समोर झालं ना, म्हणजे टायटन, तनिष्क, आयसीएस,
इनोव्हेशन इन बिग बाजार किंवा डीमार्ट, दे हॅव स्टार्टेड बाईंग स्टफ इन बल्क अँड सेलिंग इट आउट. म्हणजे आपल्याला वाटतं की ते थर्ड क्लास, इट्स नॉट अ गुड क्वालिटी मे बी किंवा काय, आणि दॅट इज द रिझन दे आर सेलिंग इट अट सच अ लो प्राइस, किंवा ह्याच्यावर हे फ्री किंवा त्याच्यावर ते फ्री. पण ऍक्च्युली इफ यू सी दे आर बाईंग इट इन सो मच बल्क क्वांटिटी, तर त्याच्यामुळे त्यांना ते इझिली अफोर्डेबल होऊ शकतं. म्हणजे बाईंग इन बल्क इज ऑलवेज रेकमेंडेड, सो दॅट यू आर,
सो दे हॅव इनोव्हेटेड इन देअर पर्चेसिंग पॅटर्न. एम आय राईट मॅम?
पर्चेसिंग, येस, पर्चेसिंग पॅटर्न अँड एज वेल एज देअर सेल्स पॅटर्न. बिकॉज इफ यू, if they are giving us buy one get one free, obviously a person who wants to spend 1000 will end up spending 3000 in their outlet. True. And in the long run, sir, definitely the firm is benefited rather than at a loss, because where a person has gone to buy one thing, he has bought 10 unnecessary things on the same purchase.
Correct. Okay, any other company you want to pick up, any other company? Again,
blood sample collections, what they have tapped is the gap in the market. Manje, rather than people coming to them, they have changed their mode of operation.
Okay. Which company you are referring to? Kutli company sangili tumhi ata, sorry, I missed that particular name of the company.
Blood sample collections.
Sample collection. That's the most essential thing, basic thing, is it not? So because we have so many people, we definitely can go extend. So now this kind of a service, very few companies can give, very few countries can make it happen. But see, we have done it, and that's exactly. So again, because this is a very short workshop, so I don't want to go every company by company. So how really we innovate? So let's understand some theory, and that way you will be able to get the complete idea. So basically, first is the ideation, then we talk about research, planning, prototyping, and launch. Now here, when we are talking about ideation, okay, and research, this is where we do not come up to the mark. Apan jagacha javalpas pan pochat nahi ideation ani research madhe. Ithe je kai kaam kele paije te apan khare arthane karat nahi. Then comes the planning part of it, definition part of it. Again, we don't do that. Third comes as a prototype and tyachyavarti testing and tyachyavarti anek mato magavun ghenam आणि त्याच्यामध्ये इम्प्रूव्हमेंट करणं आणि फायनली प्रॉडक्ट लॉन्च करणं, इथपर्यंत पोहोचायला आपल्याला एवढा वेळ लागतो, आपण घाईतच असतो कायम. अँड देन व्हॉट हॅपन्स, यु नो, देन ऍक्च्युअली इनोव्हेशन डझंट हॅपन. सो व्हॉट टू इनोव्हेट, मला वाटतं आता ह्या पर्टिक्युलर स्लाईडवरती आपण थोडा वेळ घालवायचा आहे. सो फर्स्ट अँड फॉर्मस्ट थिंग, जेव्हा ही स्लाईड पूर्ण होईल ना, तेव्हा माझी इच्छा आहे की निदान 4-5 लोकांनी सांगावं की काही तुम्हाला आयडिया मिळाल्या का. सो पहिली गोष्ट म्हणजे ऍप्लिकेशन ऑफ स्किल. की हा तर सगळ्यात सोपा मार्ग सगळ्यांकडे, म्हणजे तुमच्याकडे भले एक एम्प्लॉई असेल किंवा तुम्ही 5 सप्लायरकडनं काम करून घेत असाल किंवा तुमची कंपनी खूप मोठी असेल, पण जे काही आपण शिकलोय, जे काही आपल्याकडे स्किल आहे, ती सगळीच्या सगळी आपण आपल्या जॉबमध्ये इम्प्लिमेंट केली आहेत का. हॅव वी रिअली डन ऑन जॉब इम्प्लिमेंटेशन, ऑन जॉब ऍप्लिकेशन? ओके, इट्स अ बिग थिंग. आय बिलीव्ह दिस इज वाय ऍक्च्युली यू विल गेट मॅक्झिमम बेनिफिट इफ यू इनोव्हेट इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर वन एरिया. सेकंड, इन टर्म्स ऑफ प्रोडक्ट, इन टर्म्स ऑफ फंक्शनॅलिटी, look and feel. This everybody has to improve. There is a lot of scope to improve on this. Then we talk about various services which we are giving. So in terms of our availability, in terms of our range, in terms of our capacity, in terms of our capability, so services also can be improved multifold. People can improve this particular services multifold. When it comes to processes which you are implementing in your own company, now processes in terms of quality, quantity, cost, time. So continuous process refinement, continuous process tightening or process improvement will always give you a sustainable benefits. So when we talk about sustainability, I believe you have to look at the process. So you had a processes pre-March, a particular process was there, but now the environment has changed so much. So it's again the time to tighten your seat belts and again come out with your proper processes. That will give you another stuff. Then strategy, whether you want to be global or local. Nothing wrong being only local, being only in a small niche area and a small area, nothing wrong. My suggestion to you would be, there's one example which I can give you. I don't know how many of you have gone to Nashik. Okay. So my suggestion, some domain, whether you want to be in single, working with a single domain or multiple domain. Now these days with many SMEs, when I listen to them, they will always say that we have got multiple verticals, as if they have got a huge people and very big investment which is going on. People are only two or three, but they talk that we are working in multiple verticals. Rather than they can say, okay, we provide services in multiple areas, but we use all big terminologies. Don't get into that. So decide in which domain we want to work. Systematic approach, big picture, focused, how are we going to go about it? Then business model. Now these are multiple business models. It could be brokerage, it could be franchisee filling, it could be crowdsourcing, so on and so forth. So what is your business model? How are you going to, or it is a self-funded, you can go about that as well. And secondly, relationship building. Now, many times, just by building relationship, also you can expand your business. See, right now, Karade Business Brahman Group is nothing but relationship building group. Networking group, but it is actually relationship building groups. My suggestion to you would be, these are the various areas where we can innovate. And under these particular areas, there can be certain sub areas which we can come out with. And you can really focus on one or two areas per quarter or per 6 months and do a fantastic job there. The rest of the benefits you will get in other areas very easily. But what happens is that we tend to work on multiple areas. आणि मग ज्याला मराठीत म्हणतात ना, एक ना धड बराबर चिंध्या. एनी कमेंट्स? आय एम ओपन फॉर कमेंट्स नाउ. एनी कमेंट्स?
याच्यात स्ट्रॅटेजिक हा जो एक पॉइंट मेन्शन केलाय सर तुम्ही, ग्लोबल किंवा लोकल, त्याला थोडस अजून इलॅबोरेट कराल का? म्हणजे दॅट इज पर्टेनिंग टू मोर ऑफ मार्केटिंग ऍस्पेक्ट इज व्हॉट यू मीन.
सो मॅम, यू बीइंग एन आर्किटेक्ट, you can clearly say that, okay, I am going to provide service in Asia Pacific region. I am going to provide service only India's western region.
Okay.
Global doesn't mean that you have to go in all the countries. But you can define that where I want to really go. Or sometimes people may say, no, I will work only in Maharashtra using all local material, which is in a 25 kilometer radius. And that's my specialization of architect. Architecture. So that's a completely different specialty than what we really are talking about, ma'am.
Right. Okay.
Any other comment? Thank you. Thank you, Falguni ma'am. Any other? Anyone else? तुम्ही थोडं बोर करते का तुम्हाला?
सर, डोमेन मध्ये तुम्ही जे म्हटलं. हॅलो.
हा, बोला बोला.
तर पर्टिक्युलरली आता कोविड नंतर प्रत्येक जण असं म्हणतंय की तुम्ही एका बिझनेस मध्ये असण्यापेक्षा तुम्ही वेगवेगळ्या दोन तीन बिझनेस मध्ये असण्याची गरज आहे. त्याच्यावर तुला थोडं इलॅबोरेट करू का प्लीज?
ती काय होतं माहितीये का, आपला जर आपल्या बिझनेस वरती विश्वासच नसेल ना, आपला जर आपल्या बिझनेस वरती विश्वासच नसेल ना आणि समजा फायनान्शियल क्रंच प्रचंड आला असेल ना म्हणजे फायनान्शियल प्रेशर प्रमाणाबाहेर आलं असेल ना तर नक्कीच दुसरं काहीतरी एक्सप्लोर करावं. पण प्रत्येक बिझनेसचा असं स्वतःचा एक सायकल असतो, आपल्याला अप असतो आणि आपल्याला डाऊन असतो. आणि सपोज तुम्ही तुमच्या बिझनेसची 2 किंवा 3 सायकल पाळलेले असतील ना तर तुम्हाला इव्हन आत्ताचा आलेला प्रॉब्लेम पण एवढा मोठा वाटणार नाही. नो डाऊट इट इज अ लाईफ अँड डेथ सिच्युएशन, बट ऍज फार एज बिझनेस इज कन्सर्न्ड इट इज वन पर्टिक्युलर अब्रप्ट सायकल विच हॅज कम इन. आता बघा इथे मी बघतोय की लोक तसे बऱ्यापैकी सिनियर आहेत, म्हणजे तुम्ही नक्कीच 3-4 स्लोडाऊन तो बघितलेत ना. Y2K चा स्लोडाऊन बघितला, 2008 चा तुम्ही स्लोडाऊन पाहिला, 2012 चा स्लोडाऊन पाहिला. म्हणजे असं नाहीये की तुम्ही स्लोडाऊन पाहिलेले नाहीयेत. आणि प्रत्येक बिझनेसचा स्लोडाऊन हा वेगळा वेगळा असतो. सो मी व्हॉट इज राईट व्हॉट इज रॉंग असं नाही, माझं असं म्हणणं एवढंच आहे की समजा फायनान्शियल प्रेशर प्रचंड आली असतील आणि कुठल्याही परिस्थितीत सपोज मी आता दुसरीकडे हातपाय नाही मिळले तर मला काहीच करता येणार नाही, येस एक्सप्लोर द डोमेन प्रोव्हाइडेड यू हॅव अ सम एक्सपर्ट इन दॅट पर्टिक्युलर एरिया. पण ब्लाइंडली शॉर्ट्स प्लीज मारू नका, तुमचे आहेत ते पैसे पण सगळे निघून जातील. ओके एनिवे सो
पाटील साहेब,
या गो अहेड
कॅन आय इंटरप्ट?
या या आय इंटरप्ट नाही, एव्हरीबडी इज मोस्ट वेलकम.
या या
प्लीज
यू सी what you have mentioned here is theoretically absolutely right.
Sir, I am talking
but
practical.
The question in front of a small businessman or medium businessman.
I am talking practical. This word theory we have to use very carefully.
No, I am coming to that. Why I said theoretically? You see, there are two scenarios which are in front of me. One is that I try to say, I do sequentially, that I try to first improve the product functionality look, then I look for the service. That is one thing, then it will be too late to do anything, I think. That is one this thing. If I try to do all these 7-8 activities simultaneously, perhaps I do not have the capacity to do it. So what you will suggest as a via media or median of all those things, I think if you can concentrate, because when I say theoretical, means yes, generally everybody will say who has spent some time in business, ki all these things should be done. But we require your guidance exactly on this, ki how to prioritize these particular things. Because I said, as if you
sir, hold on. See, you were not paying attention to my slides. I started my session with this, where to focus. Do you see my slide, sir?
Yeah, I saw all the
slides. No, you did not see the current slide. I started with this. So I said very clearly, in the current terrible time, apply what you have. And then I said, pick any of the area which is appropriate. I never said use all. I'm so sorry to interrupt you. The reason being, this is how the sessions are misinterpreted.
Okay.
So I'm not saying that.
So now,
I have already.
I get it.
Okay. So I'm so sorry if I pushed you hard. The reason being, what happens, you know, as a consultant, my job is to give the right thing. And secondly, mala rashtra nirman karayche. Tyachyamule mi asa shortcut nahi deu shakat. I will give you complete. Okay. Saraswati Pujan challe majhe. I'm teaching right now.
It's perfectly okay.
Okay. So basically, I'm giving you some examples. I'm giving you some examples of innovative products. And इथे तुमच्या लक्षात येईल की तुम्हाला भरपूर स्कोप आहे, ऍब्सोल्युटली भरपूर स्कोप आहे. ओके, आता इथे अनेक एरियामध्ये इनोव्हेशन झालेली आहेत आणि प्रत्येक इनोव्हेशन हे काही पैसे मिळालेच पाहिजे म्हणून करत आहेत. जे इनोव्हेटिव्ह किंवा क्रिएटिव्ह लोक असतात ना, त्यांची क्रिएटिव्हिटी अशी फ्लो होत असते कंटिन्युअसली. अँड दे विल ऑलवेज कम आउट विथ द प्रोडक्ट्स, दे विल ऑलवेज कम आउट विथ द प्रोडक्ट्स, दे विल कम आउट विथ द व्हेरी व्हेरी डिफरंट आयडियाज. Now these are some more stuff which I am just showing. Now here, a staircase. Now again, now this is for the kid, what they are talking about. Now these are all innovative products. And you can see multiple such products. Now this is what precisely, this ID Idli is one which I am very much impressed, which is coming from South India. Now see, they are giving us an Idli batter in such a way by which you can create a Medu Vada very easily, the middle product what we are talking about. Look at our grocery shop owner, a complete innovative approach of selling something. When this particular malls came in, everybody thought these grocery stores will go out of business, but they innovated. They extended their service hours and they started giving us everything from breakfast to our dinner time, whatever is required. Secondly, they started home service. Even in this particular COVID bad patch also, grocery people have actually helped us so much. I believe we should be indebted to them. On top of it, we should be also thankful to the people in uniforms. The doctors, the people who are standing on the road as a policeman, the cleaners, etc. People are innovative. People are innovative. We only look at innovation only from a big perspective. My suggestion to you would be, innovation is always in and around you. And when you look at these particular innovations, you will realize that we also can innovate a lot. And that is where precisely I am coming to the point that our business, if at all we take it seriously and we focus and we use all the brain available of our employees and our suppliers and our customers all put together, I don't think your business will ever have any problem. We only need to, now the last one which I am talking about, the candles. Now this is a classic innovation which has been done by this particular gentleman, is it not? My suggestion to you would be, we have to be extremely open. So what we need, what are the nutrients at every stage of innovation? Now see, you also in your business would be at a different stage of innovation. I am not saying that you are not doing innovation, but you might not be aware that, okay, this is innovation all about. So basically there is a birth. So your mindset should be there, your associative should, the thinking should be there, and the articulation should be there. Articulation is very, very important. A lot of time we don't articulate things right and the misunderstanding happens. Third is the infancy stage where you already have started. At that time, open-mindedness, overcoming obstacles and risk-taking. And that is where precisely as a CEO of the company or as a person or maybe the person main in charge of the company, the failures which are coming in, you should be really supporting them. Those particular obstacles have to be really taken care of. Third is the childhood. During that particular innovative stage, learning from failure, somebody was talking about that we have to learn from our younger generation, the way they go, the way they are adopting, coping with the opposition. See, opposition will definitely come. Now, whenever opposition comes in, we really have to be coping up with that. We should not be succumbing to that kind of a stuff. Then comes the adolescence, where a disciplined development. Now, when the disciplined development is going on, at that point in time, do not allow anybody to change randomly what is being planned. Don't. At that time, be extremely, extremely disciplined. Like a military kind of a execution has to be really done. Okay. Acting fast, but with thoughtfulness. Young adult, where your process skills, social skills, and networking skills become very, very important. So I know, since you are into this particular networking kind of a stuff, you actually are into a young adult sort of innovation. So this is where your process skills will come. Then comes the maturity stage, where you are observing sanitization, articulation, and cultural awareness, that in which market we have to go. So the way Ms. Falguni ma'am, you asked me that, okay, global and local. So, okay, you are entering a new market. Obviously, you have to learn the new rules. We can't say that, okay, here the rules are such, I will just go with those particular similar rules. And then it gets into an aging kind of a format. It's about application, innovation, entrepreneurship, and change management. Now, you may say that change is required everywhere. Yes, that is constant, no doubt about it. But especially when your business or a product is at an aging stage. At that point in time, accepting change management is most essential, and it has to be really accepted fast. It will definitely give you a lot of hiccups, but it's okay. By the way, I'm slightly going faster because otherwise some portion might not get covered, and I don't want you to really get deprived of the full knowledge. So phases and simplified innovation process, conceptualize, implementation, and marketing. Okay, conceptual. Now my suggestion, this one particular slide will give you an idea. So where we go with the requirement analysis, idea generation, ideation. So wherever you are, now there is a likelihood that you may have taken an agency of some good product. You may have taken an agency of good product. At that point in time, you are into either implementation or marketing stage. So you already have given some premium for the company which is innovative. Possible, whatever be the case, my suggestion, go with that particular stuff. Now here again, I'm giving you a few companies and I'm leaving this particular discussion open for next couple of minutes. Now see, these are the companies which I see. I'm talking only from a Indian as well as some other technological kind of a companies. I leave it to you open. This particular slide is for reading purpose because I'm not going to get into too much of a detail about this. But the way companies are focusing themselves and how are they going? And here I want you to pick up one of the company and then start telling me about it. Any company, you pick any company which you feel appropriate.
हॅलो.
यस, गो अहेड प्लीज. ओपन
बजाज ऑटो.
ओके.
न्यू प्रोडक्ट्स गिव अप स्कूटर.
या.
ओके. अँड वाय आय एम आय कुड गेट कनेक्टेड विथ देम इज दॅट वी आर बेसिकली आय एम अ सिव्हिल इंजिनियर.
Okay.
And I came out as a civil engineer, worked for a few years as a civil engineer. Uh-huh. But when I came into projects, then I realized that I cannot be only civil engineer. I need to be aware of all the other engineering aspects.
No,
and today, apart from civil engineering, we are taking up electrical engineering projects. We are taking up mechanical engineering projects.
No,
practically, there is no field in engineering which we are not now. So, we are open for and we have developed new products also in engineering, which is not my core area,
yeah.
But which is just now we use the COVID for our benefit that the Eastern markets wherein nobody was ready to work, simply Malaysia, Indonesia, and now even in Thailand.
Okay.
We said we are ready and we can give you offline support. Through internet, and we resolve their problems which was not a civil engineering field, and in fact there were some companies wherein we introduce Indian people who can give the solutions for their problems wherein the local market people were not giving.
Lovely. That's exactly what I'm saying. See how companies are moving ahead. Every people might not be using the word innovation every now and then, but actually they are focusing on different stuff to achieve their targets. Okay, this particular slide was precisely to show you that, okay, in your business also you will find this particular niche and you can really go ahead. Okay, so now we move ahead that how we are going to bring this particular innovation. So again, a few self-review questions which I want to really ask you, because now we are moving towards design thinking. So why are you doing what you are doing? Now this particular one question, many people don't answer honestly. Then why are we doing what we are doing? See first, why I am doing a particular thing, and then why we are doing a particular thing, and there is a way to do it better, and that's exactly what we really have to find it as soon as possible, especially in the testing time. And that is why if you at all we want the edge over others or edge over competition, there has to be a value creation and value capture. Many times you would be giving a lot of value to your customer, but it is not getting captured. You are not marketing, you are not talking about it. My suggestion to you would be, don't get into that particular zone. So here are a few action points. Of course, this is a big exercise which I conduct with companies. So I'm going to take two or three challenges here, and I want you to tell me that, okay, which are the areas, which are the action points you need to counter this particular challenge. Is that fine? So this is a design thinking exercise which I generally take. So, okay, how to be accountable? What do you think? What is essential? Give me just number 1, 2, 3, whatever you feel appropriate. I know all 10 are not really essential for this. Anyone?
Accountable maybe in terms of delivering your services or the quality services.
Total ownership. What all things you want has been given here. Which one will you implement? I'll do one thing. I'll show you 3-4. You can pick whichever you want and give me the solution. Okay, chal. I'll just open the whole stuff for you. Okay.
Okay.
Pick anything and tell me what actions you will take. Pick anything, whichever is appropriate for your business. For your business, by the way. Sorry?
Accountability, it could be in terms of whatever has been done by showing whatever examples has been done or implemented in one particular fashion.
Okay.
Which gives you an edge over the others.
Okay.
In terms of your services or products.
See, I have given here 10 action points. Just pick something from this itself.
Okay.
right now. So that it becomes faster. Otherwise, see, we will not be able to complete that stuff.
Statistics of actions, maybe.
Yeah, which one?
Statistics of actions.
Lovely. Okay, pick something else. Somebody should pick something else, whichever. Maybe somebody should pick up this particular F, closing the cell. For closing the cell, what actions are essential?
Number seven.
Okay, demonstrate capabilities. Okay, closing the cell. Okay, what else? Is that the only one essential or anything else is essential? I think number three is also essential for closing the cell, sir.
Deliberation.
Proper closure is number three is more important.
Lovely. Okay. See what happens, you know, when we play this particular game in the class, that is when deciding the company, we come out with the challenges which that particular company is facing. Okay, we come out with the list of the challenges, and then finally it comes out in such a way that there are hardly four or five actions which that particular company takes. Most of their problems can be taken care of, and a lot of times we think that for every problem we have to have some different actions. That's not the case, and that's why I'm saying that innovation doesn't mean that you have to get into all the areas. Get into a particular area, prioritize that particular area, and ensure that all your entire brain in the company, I'm not saying get all the employees, but all the people who are really enterprising, who are really having a lot of enthu, they will come out with the solution and you'll be able to easily implement. And that's why ultimately we are in the business so that we want to go ahead of competition. And that's why first and foremost thing, what is controllable, what is within our control, that we should be taking care. So the smart work and hard work, there's no substitute for this. Then what you want to control, I'm talking about, you have to be efficient and effective. So your efficiency and effectiveness, that means you all need to go in a process driven way. And then you want to be influencer, at that time you should be showing leadership and performance. So here, what you want to control, your processes are coming in place. When you want to become an influencer, you want to influence something in your own area, in your domain, in your business, in your area, whatever, leadership will come in the play. And when we talk about non-controllables, when it is completely non-controllable, you have to do risk management exceptionally well. Your management skills have to be superb. And of course, again, a complete focus on process. And that's exactly right now what we are going to talk about. And that's why, that is where precisely I'm talking about. So to begin with, there may not be any design. So you will start doing designing as a styling. Then you will start design as a process and design as a strategy. Ultimately, these four steps every company goes through. Initially, there may not be any focus on design per se, can be understood. But ultimately, you have to reach to the stage where a designing should be part of your company's strategy. Designing should be part of your company's strategy. And that is where my suggestion to you would be, iterative design process becomes much easier, because in first go, the design might not be absolutely the way you want. And that's why you have to able to get into multiple iterations. And when you get into multiple iterations, you will realize that sometimes it may become a painful process, but the end design is superb. The end is always, always superb. Okay. So, by the way, something has gone wrong with this particular slide. Let me quickly correct this slide. Just give me 1 minute, please. Something has gone wrong with this slide. Just a moment. I'll correct it on the fly. Don't worry. I'll not take a lot of time for correcting it. Yeah. So basically, this is a traditional way what we really have seen in terms of designing. But now what happens, you know, what is the right question? You have to form the right question. Unless you define, it's not going to get into intuitive mode. Design with what is available, build for insight, listen more. Now this is precisely is a key success. If you listen more to your suppliers, to your employees, to your customers, to the society who's going to use your product, then get outside approach. Outside opinions are very essential. Learn through stories. Start talking stories. Tell stories about your own company, your product. Listen to the stories, what are happening. Experience, multiple experiences is essential. Talk about the feeling. See, a lot of time in design thinking, the feeling of a customer is very, very important. You need to collaborate. And of course, it should be inspiring. That is, revolutionary design has to be done in the entire game. So what we're really looking here is a business model design, which is lean canvas, then lean startup scientific, and then job to be done. In short, viable, feasible, and desirable. And intersection, what we get is a continuous innovation process. So when we talk about design thinking, there are only five steps: empathize, define, ideate, prototype, and test. Now it is so simple. It is so simply been given. So when we empathize there, develop a deep understanding of the challenge. Develop a deep understanding of the challenge. When we talk about define, clarify, articulate the problem you want to solve. And let me tell you, this is where we lack our capability. I'm not saying all of you, but most of the people lack capability in definition itself. And that's why you will find that people talk too many sentences to define their problem. They will start filing all the history, geography, but the problem. And then we tend to tell a person, come to the point quickly. But the person is interested only in talking because he's in love with his own voice. He's in love with his own voice so much that he doesn't stop. So people like me, we stop those, that particular person, bus, because you're not able to come to the point. Ideate. Moment you define it correctly, ideation will start. Ideation doesn't start because we don't define it correctly. And let me tell you, everybody has a capability of being creative. Then comes the disciplined approach, like creation of a prototype, where we go to various builders and we see a sample flat. Sample flat is nothing but a prototype. Are you with me? And based on that prototype, we can make it. You go to Home Decor, and they show you, okay, how the bedroom will look like, how the kitchen will look like, modular kitchen, so on and so forth. These are all prototypes. So creation of prototype will give you a lot of acceptance from customer. And then you can go for testing and then final rollout. Such a simple process. Empathize, define, ideate, prototype, and test. So innovation, whatever you do, has to get into this particular zone. Will not get to this particular question right now. So what we talk about, we have to understand, observe, come to the point of view. Now this is important. Understand, observe, and then come to the point of view. But what happens is, you know, we quickly come to the point of view. That's the problem. Secondly, then you go, once you come with the point of view, then go with the ideate, prototype, and test. Now here, the same process, slightly elaborated, which talks about empathize and define. That is where we talk about understand. That is the inspiration. Then we talk about ideate and prototype. That's what we talk about, explore. We are exploring the entire game, ideation. And then we talk about testing and implementation. That is what is materialized. So finally, we materialize the whole stuff. So you understand that even the entire process, you can put it in only three steps. Okay, we'll not get into this. And that is why prototype will always give you. If a picture is worth 1,000 words, a prototype is worth 1,000 meetings. So show the prototype. In short, sample flat. Sample flat is prototype. Always keep it at the back of your mind. Show your customer a prototype. Chances of sale getting closed is very, very high. You all are Thanekers. You go to Prashant Corner. He will always give you some sample. Zara Navin Barfi test karun baga. Correct? And the moment you test it, there's every possibility that you buy it. Correct? And again, this is the last slide. So always go with the high benefit and easy to implementation first. That will give you, because in such testing time and such a bad time, I don't think we have to really get into the zone where we want to invest more. So design is not just what it looks like and feels like. Many people, they are in their dream world, but Steve Jobs clearly said, design is how it works. It has to work smoothly. And that's why, how do I approach the challenge? How do I interpret my findings? Interpretation of finding is very, very important. Otherwise, I know everything. We get into that particular zone. Don't. That's where the young lady was talking about, learn from younger generation. What do we create? How do I build my idea? And how do I provide and improve the idea? Becomes very, very important. Again, we'll not get into this particular detailed slide because, again, for the paucity of time, I am quickly coming to my last and the most important stop and the most important slide. That is this, where I'm talking about life and career skills are essential, learning and innovation skills are essential, and information, media, and technological skills are essential. That's the core subject of 21st century. And that's why standards and assessments, okay? curriculum and instructions, professional development, learning environment. Now this will give you maximum benefits. So yeah, time as per my clock is 5:57. And now I'll leave it open for question answers. I might not have all the ready-made answers, but I'll definitely make use of the groups entire intelligence and we will solve our problems. Thank you very much. It's open for question answers.
Sachin Tatke here. So I probably missed one or two slides in the beginning, but I think your concept that ideation, I really agree. And mala asa vaatte ki ideation of really innovative products, you know, it requires R&D, R&D research and development, kiwa some monetary investment, or basically funds are required to create an idea and to do some prototype.
Yes.
And this process can take time. And by the time we launch it, or maybe before it becomes available in the market, or maybe even after it is available, if it is possible to recreate it, म्हणजे पटकन कोणी कॉपी करू शकत असेल, तर मग we have to go back to the drawing board. So you know, your you need to have enough funds. तुम्हाला जर हे create करायचं असेल ना, तर maybe that is why probably the Indian I don't know, I am just asking you, की आपल्याकडे फंड्सचा इश्यू गेले अनेक वर्ष आहे. सो इन जनरल तो वी टेंड टू हॅव अ ट्रेडिंग मेंटॅलिटी, की आपण हे इथून घेतलं तर हाऊ डू वी ऍड्रेस दॅट, बिकॉज मध्ये विशेष सायकल सारखं होतं असं मला वाटतं.
मी तुम्हाला एक क्विक सांगू, मे बी आतापर्यंत ज्या काही 5-10 कंपन्यांमध्ये या गोष्टी केल्या आहेत, होतं तसं नाही का, आपण आपल्या प्रॉफिट मधला एक पर्टिक्युलर पोर्शन हा डेव्हलपमेंट साठी ठेवतच नाही आणि तिथे आपण मार्क होतो. आणि दुसरं म्हणजे आपण हे जे घाबरतो ना की कोणीतरी माझं प्रॉडक्ट कॉपी करेल, अहो किरकोळ बुद्धीचे लोक कॉपीच करणार हो, पण जर आपल्याकडे क्रिएटिव्हिटी आहे, आपल्याकडे जर ताकद आहे ना, कोण तुम्हाला टच करू शकत नाही. साधारणपणे 12 वर्षापूर्वी जेव्हा मी बिझनेसमध्ये आलो आणि प्रोजेक्ट मॅनेजमेंट स्पेशलिस्ट होतो, प्रोजेक्ट मॅनेजमेंट हा माझा कोर एरिया, मला इतक्या लोकांनी घाबरवलं की अरे जाम प्रॉब्लेम आहे, एवढी कॉम्पिटिशन आहे. आणि मला कोणी कॉम्पिटिशन नाहीये, कारण जे तुमचे कस्टमर असतात ना ते तुमचेच कस्टमर असतात. दुसरी गोष्ट म्हणजे अनेक लोक कॉपी करतात, बरं करू देत ना, अहो धंदा एवढा अवेलेबल आहे जगामध्ये, एवढा अवेलेबल आहे, आपल्याला काही कमी नाहीये. म्हणजे मी तर नेहमी म्हणतो की धंदा अबॅन्डन्स आहे, का आपण कॉम्पीट करतो लोकांशी. कमॉन विथ युअर प्रॉडक्ट अँड शो. तुम्हाला माहिती आपण फक्त चितळे बाकरवाडीत म्हणतो, पण तिथे काका हलवाईंची बाकरवाडी खा एवढी अफलातून आहे, त्या लोकांना मार्केटिंगच करते ना, हे त्यांना कुठे जाऊन सांगायला पाहिजे ना. आपल्या ठाण्यामध्ये पण बघा, आपल्या ठाण्यामध्ये पण लोणची इतक्या प्रकारची मिळतात, पण त्या लोकांनी ठरवलं की नाही आम्ही एवढ्या एरियामध्येच करणार आणि ते तिथेच परफेक्ट काम करतात. कोणी हा आणि नथिंग इज रॉंग, नथिंग इज रॉंग, पण शेवटी प्रत्येकाची कॅपॅसिटी, रिस्क बेअरिंग ॲबिलिटी पाहिजे, पण एक थोडा पोर्शन ना डेव्हलपमेंटसाठी ठेवला पाहिजे, तो आपण ठेवतच नाही. आणि त्यामुळे आपण आपल्याकडे काय माहिती आहे, आपल्याकडे सक्सेस म्हणजे काय की त्याच्यापेक्षा मी स्वस्त देतो. अरे काय मेंटॅलिटी आहे यार, म्हणजे त्याला त्याच्या बिलो द बेल्ट मारून मी उभारणार, दिस इज नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क फॉर इन द लॉंग. आणि आता तर कोविड नंतर तर इम्पॉसिबल आहे. तुम्हाला माहिती आहे अनेक ठिकाणी आम्ही कन्सल्टिंग राहतो, लोक काय काय ऐकवतात आम्हाला, कन्सल्टंट येतात नुसते ऍडवाइस देऊन निघून जातात. आम्ही जाऊ घेऊ नका ना, आम्हाला आम्ही काय आलेलो नाही तुमच्याकडे. पण आल्यानंतर निदान बघा काय हवं, तर बरं क्रिएटिव्हिटी सतत वाहत असते, आम्ही पटापट तुम्हाला आयडिया देऊन निघून जातो. मी तुम्हाला नाही पैसे देऊ नका, पण डोंट अंडर एस्टिमेट द अदर पर्सन क्रिएटिव्हिटी. सो सचिन साहेब, तुम्ही जे सांगितलं ना क्रिएटिव्हिटी असते आपण करतो, फक्त थोडासा फंड कमी पडतो. मला वाटतं थोडा थोडा फंड साईडला काढा आणि तो त्याच्यासाठी फक्त वापरा. आय नो, आय एम सो सॉरी, समजा मी थोडं जास्त पुश केलं किंवा फास्ट गेलो असेल तर, कारण काय एका तास हो एक तास दिला तर मी काय 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 करणार ना. ओके, सो इफ देर आर नो क्वेश्चन, तुमच्याकडे माझा नंबर आहे सगळा आहे, यू कॅन व्हेरी वेल कॉल मी.
परत एकदा तुमचा नंबर आणि त्याची स्लाइड जरा शेअर कराल का?
हो लगेच करतो.
आणि दुसरी गोष्ट म्हणजे जे आम्हाला नेहमी वाटतं, माझ्या बिझनेस मधले माझे जे गाईड आहेत, ही ऑलवेज सेज की ज्या लिमिट्स असतात त्या तुमच्या मनात असतात. म्हटलं तर लिमिट्स या तुमच्या मनात असतात, अदरवाइज काहीच हे नाहीये.
की कसं आहे ना, आपण खरंच लकी होत, म्हणजे भारतामध्ये एवढी क्रिएटिव्हिटी आहे, पण आपल्याला खूप गडबड करतात, खूप गडबड करतात. सस्टेनेबल होत आपण, माहितीये का, आणि खूप लोकांना हेच मांडता येत नाही सस्टेनेबल होत म्हणून. त्यामुळे आपण आपल्याला नेहमी म्हणतो की अरे आम्ही काय, आम्ही डेव्हलपिंग कंट्री, अरे हो पण वी आर सस्टेनेबल, कहीं जाते नहीं है बॉस, खुद का राज खुद चलाते हैं। ओके थैंक यू वेरी मच एवरीबडी, आणि धन्यवाद। फक्त माझा मित्र नाहीये संजय, तेवढंच जरा एक गडबड झालेली आहे माझी, पण अदरवाईज बरं वाटलं पण सगळ्यांना बघून। संजय कुणाबद्दल बोलवत आहे मला कळलं आज सगळ्यांना बघितल्यामुळे बरं वाटलं। थँक्यू व्हेरी मच सर फॉर इन्व्हायटिंग मी।
ओके केबीबीएफच्या वतीने मी पण तुम्हाला थँक्यू म्हणते। विषय खूप मोठा होता आणि वेळ खूप थोडा, तरी आम्हाला एक खूप छान ओव्हरव्ह्यू मिळाला आणि आय एम शुअर सगळ्यांच्याच विचारांना चालना मिळाली असेल आणि अ लॉट ऑफ क्रिएटिव्हिटी अँड इनोव्हेशन विल फॉलो। थँक्यू सो मच सर, आणि तुमचे कॉन्टॅक्ट आमच्याकडे आहेतच, सो यू कॅन डेफिनेटली एक्सपेक्ट कॉल्स फ्रॉम सम ऑफ अस।
मी तर नक्कीच करणार आहे, कारण इट वॉज सो रिफ्रेशिंग आफ्टर ऑल द निगेटिव्हिटी इन कोविड एरिया कोविड टाइम्स। आणि मला खूप बरं वाटलं की असेही कन्सल्टंट आहेत की जे म्हणतात अबंडन्स विच इज सो व्हायटल टुडे, की वी हॅव एव्हरीथिंग, ओनली थिंग ते म्हणतो तर सगळे काखेत कसं गावाला आपल्याला माहित नाही, आपल्याकडे आहे सगळं, तर त्यातनं आपण ते शोधून काढलं पाहिजे। आणि नक्कीच म्हणजे मी फॉर माय कंपनी डेफिनेटली आय विल कॉल यू, अँड कारण हा एका तास फारच कमी आहे, आणि डेफिनेटली आय विल थँक फाल्गुनी की त्यांनी तिने तुम्हाला इंट्रोड्यूस केलं, सो इट वॉज आय थिंक टू आवर बेनिफिट, सो थँक्यू व्हेरी मच।
थँक्यू चलो थँक्यू व्हेरी मच।
या थँक्यू,
सो लेट्स क्लोज द मीटिंग हियर। थँक्यू एव्हरीवन फॉर जॉइनिंग इन।
Thank you. Nice meeting you all.
Thank you.
Sulva, bandha kar.